First, we need to find little zl. So we take zl over z naught. We get 0.5 over j2. We've done this before. And then we need to plot this on the Smith chart. And we can do that by finding where the 0.5 r equal 0.5 circle intersects the arc of j positive 2. So here is zl plotted on the Smith chart. Then we can find the reflection coefficient magnitude by using the radial scale at the bottom of the Smith chart. Measure the distance from the center of the Smith chart to the impedance dot. So that's right here. Measure that distance, say with a ruler, and then measure the same distance along the reflection coefficient magnitude scale at the bottom of the Smith chart. So from starting from here, where it's zero, measure out that same distance. We find for this example that the reflection coefficient magnitude is 0.82. Now that was just for the magnitude of the reflection coefficient. The reflection coefficient can be a complex number, so it can also have a phase associated with it. For the angle of the reflection coefficient, we will use one of the inner two scales along the outside of the Smith chart. Use the scale labeled angle of reflection coefficient in degrees. Remember that the reflection coefficient at the load of a transmission line is written as the magnitude times e to the j theta r. So when we plot the load impedance, we can find the corresponding theta r at the load using this scale, the angle of reflection coefficient. And the magnitude, of course, we just saw how to do that. To find theta r, we draw a straight line from the center of the Smith chart through the impedance dot and through this angle of reflection coefficient in degrees scale on the outside of the Smith chart. The value that you read off here is the reflection coefficient in degrees. So that would give you theta r in degrees. So then, returning to our example, what is the angle of the reflection coefficient at the load?